ये ज़ुल्फ़ संवारूं और बाहों में ले लूं तुझे मैं।
तोड़ दो। So guys, as you can see, exactly 36 kilometers from McDonald's, okay? So I had refueled over there, so that is when I reset the meter. So exactly 36 kilometers from McDonald's is when you get this done. As you can see, it is showing that you have to take a right turn and this goes towards Tirupati. Now, one mistake that I made was I had set the initial location to Chennai and not to Tirupati. So because of which we missed the turn to Nellore, okay? See, Tirupati 69 kilometers. You continue straight, you go towards Chennai, which is another 130 kilometers. Don't go to that road. Take this road and go towards Tirupati and then you connect onto Bangalore Highway.
Continue on National Highway 71 for 1 kilometer.
Okay, so you continue on this road for another 1 kilometer and then you take that left turn and then that goes all the way till Tirupati, okay? So just continue on this road, do not miss this road. And another piece of advice which I want to give you guys is, when you are coming from Visakhapatnam and heading towards Bangalore, and if you want to take this Tirupati road, I recommend just next time put destination as Tirupati, head towards Tirupati, you'll get that main road, which I'll show you later on in the video. And then from there, you continue on to Bangalore Highway. Guys, like I told you, we missed one turn, that Nellore road we missed, and we've ended up here. I have no idea where we are. Look at this. 20 kilometers turn right, it seems. I don't know if you're going back to Vizag or what is happening. Google Maps is taking us on such adventurous roads, as you guys can see. Pura off-roading ka man kar raha hai. Moral of the story is, when you... don't miss the roads, and when you leave from Visakhapatnam, put the direction as Tirupati so that the GPS guides you along that Nellore road. Bhai log, ki ghanta ho gaya on this road. We are so lost. This goes to show that no matter how many times we have traveled to Bangalore from Visakhapatnam, every time we have taken the car, I don't know how this time we have just ended up in a all new route, and you know, I have absolutely no idea where this is, what is happening. So hopefully in 500 meters I have to take a right or something, and that hopefully is the road which I am familiar with. Okay Siri, please take us home safely. Siri, 200 meters turn right, please da, take us home safely da. Right on top bro. I have no idea which road this is. It at least looks like a big road. Good job Sundar Pichai, good job. Google Maps is working well. If in the middle of all of that, if you are able to show me directions, good job buddy. You know, all these nice villas or houses or offices or whatever it is, it's nice. I hadn't come to this part of Tirupati before. So interesting. And the icing on the cake is there is one red color Swift right behind us. He's been lost along with us from the initial turn. Wherever I turn the car, even he's turning, even he is gumawing everywhere. You can see him right there. He's right behind us. Things we do on every trip is some story that we have. Hai na ma? Sheeto, all our stories are told in dreams only. Finally, after all that circus and roundabouts and turnarounds and lost in everything, we've come to this road, yaar.
Whoa.
Indian Culinary Institute. We are at Indian Culinary Institute. Okay? So to all of those who are coming via Tirupati, if you have reached Indian Culinary Institute, it means you're lost. Okay, take a right turn. Where are you taking us, Siri? So you take this left turn, as you can see, Tirupati, 9 kilometers. So we just need to take this left turn right now. Finally, guys, we have reached that highway, that Tirupati bypass road. So all we need to do is now, you know, from this road, once we connect onto this highway, just continue carry on straight.
Exactly. 17 kilometers.
See, just continue for 17 kilometers and then afterwards you'll connect with the Bangalore Highway. So once we are at Bangalore Highway, then we can start flying. So the total distance still is 255 kilometers. It is showing 4 hours 35 minutes. The time right now is 4:30. So arrival might be around 9 o'clock. that's pretty decent, I guess. So yeah, now done with all the chaos, let's just stick to the main roads, not experiment any further and keep going. This is where you need to take that left turn. Like you can see, toll road starts and over here, Bengaluru 240 kilometers. Okay, so Bengaluru 240 kilometers. So 230 kilometers, the roads are absolutely beautiful. So you can fly if needed, you can cover it in 2 hours. It is not at all difficult. I'm telling you, I've done it before. It's just that right now, considering that, you know, we've traveled a long time and especially that detour really stressed me out. It's also evening time right now, going for a specific, like, you know, a special occasion. So that is why I don't want to push it too much. And also I'm trying to check how much fuel economy I'm going to get, because right now in this trip, I've tried two expensive diesels. One is the Shell Advanced Diesel, which I think V-Power Diesel something it's called, in Vizag. It costs 141 per litre, that is diesel, okay? And diesel costs more than petrol. I ran out of that fuel, then I could not find any Shell along the way, so I have refilled with Indian Oil Extra Green Diesel. That was another 103 rupees. So these are all the premium diesels of the respective brands, okay? The premium diesel of Shell and the premium diesel of Indian Oil. So I've tried both of them. Shell was very good, you know, the engine was very smooth. I've got good mileage compared to the normal diesel, which I put in HP. And Extra Green right now, I feel that the engine is too jerky, and also it is powerful, but mileage, I'm not getting good mileage. Probably it is because of those shitty roads behind, so I'm not sure. So right now I'm getting these amazing roads with that for a view. How is that for a view? Sun setting with that mountain backdrop, it looks absolutely beautiful. So let's see how much mileage I get. Right now, overall the trip, I've got 12.7, 773 kilometers in 10 hours. So let's see, another 234 kilometers. Stay tuned. So guys, right now we are at that final turn. So here you need to take a right turn. Okay, once you take a right turn, this is that Hoskote Highway. You continue on this road for the next 69 or some 100 kilometers. Later, I'll just tell you once I finish this.
Continue on Bengaluru 240 Highway for 22 kilometers.
So you continue on this road for 23 kilometers. And then even after 23 kilometers, you don't have to deviate anywhere. You just keep continuing straight. This is the Hoskote Highway. Mulbaglu Hoskote Highway. So you keep continuing on this road, you'll reach whatever destination you have to reach. I will see you in the end with the mileage of the car, the time taken for the entire distance, the total distance of the journey, and our state. As you can see, she's been sleeping the entire journey. It really is tiring. So see you in the end. Bye. So guys, finally we have made it to Bangalore. So we finally made it to Bangalore. As you guys can see, the infamous Bangalore traffic. The time currently is 7:30 PM. We have reached Bangalore. And how do we know that we have reached Bangalore? It's because of this traffic. So the total distance was 988 kilometers. And the total time taken is 12 and a half hours. And with a mileage of 12.7. Now, regarding this 12 and a half hours, it would have been quicker. You could have finished it around 12 hours, maybe 11 and a half hours. But like I told you, we took a detour and we went in that tiny road. So that is where we lost a lot of time. No, break is okay. But regarding the travel time, you know, we lost a lot of time in that tiny road. So this was the entire journey, guys, from Vishakhapatnam to Bangalore via the Tirupati road. So this route is highly recommended. The Eighth Wanderer approves, and the roads are really, really beautiful. Okay, so in spite of that delay of that chota road, you can see we have covered it in 12 and a half hours. You can easily cruise, and you know, it's comfortable speed. Well, that is it, guys. Thank you so much for watching till the end. We will catch you on the return leg. The return leg is from Bangalore to Vishakhapatnam, but there's already a video on it. So let me know down in the comments below if you want a video on it. Drive safe, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon so that you do not miss any future uploads coming up. We will see you in the next video. Bye guys.
Bye bye.
The dreaded Silk Boat Junction.
To be.
look at this.
I need to pee.
We've still not reached. It's been 2 hours. Okay, we reached at 7:30. Now the time is 9 o'clock. We have still not reached home. We're stuck in this shitty traffic. If you guys remember, initially at the starting of the video, I had told you.
I need to pee.
I had told you guys, up to you whether you want to spend 2 hours in traffic over here or whether you guys want to spend 2 hours on the highway when you come through the Chennai road.
Pee.
So this is what it is. What? Which do you recommend, Shagufta?
I need to pee.
Bichari, she needs to pee. So, which route do you recommend? Chennai wala, ye wala?
Chennai wala.
Chennai wala, because it's better and you know you can come flying on the highway. Here you're stuck in this traffic, man.
And
you're
you
just
can't
stuck.
Even pee.
Bichari, she wants to pee.
I'll cry.
I'm telling you guys, 2 hours in Bangalore traffic or 2 hours on the highway. Okay, it might be shorter distance, but dekho yaar, everybody from everywhere, they're coming and banging the car, yaar. What do I do?
Pee.
So, stupid Bangalore traffic.